Have you ever wondered why just as you finally finished cooking a delicious steak and are ready to serve your guests, someone inevitably reminds you to let the meat rest? Does meat need to rest? Is it actually tired in the first place? It turns out that letting meat rest can make eating it more enjoyable, and that's according to science. So let's explore why. I'm Sheril Kirschenbaum, and on this episode of Serving Up Science, we're cooking up some steak and exploring the science behind why most so-called experts want you to let your meat rest. Think about the last time you didn't like eating a steak or burger. Was it too tough, overly dry, dare I say, leathery? Yeah, that doesn't sound good at all. What it probably lacked was moisture. When it comes to cooking, roasting, broiling, or grilling meats, for the best flavor, letting meat rest helps keep what we often call the juices inside. Now notice I didn't say blood, it's not blood. The red colored liquid you see when cooking or cutting meat is actually water and myoglobin, which is another protein that stores oxygen and gives beef its pinkish red color. What we call white meats, like chicken and turkey, don't have as much myoglobin, which is why they appear lighter in color and can taste particularly dry. Now back to why we let meat rest. Joining me in the kitchen today is my husband and sous chef, David. Hi, honey.
Hi.
He'll be cooking up some meat for us. Well, for science. Let's get our ingredients for a medium rare strip steak. It's not all that complicated. We just need olive oil, salt, and a good skillet on a medium heat. Looking at our steak, all of that meat was once muscle on an animal. And when we add heat, a lot happens. It shrinks and gets firmer. The color changes as fat breaks down, and the water and myoglobin that we love seeps out of the steak. There are fibers in the muscle that contract and relax, which had once allowed the animal to move. These are what give meat what we tend to call its brain. Within muscle fibers are two protein threads or filaments called myosin and actin. During muscle contraction, the myosin threads grab onto actin threads, pulling them closer together. For our steak in a pan, turning up the temperature, actually changes those fibers. First, the heat breaks down myosin threads, altering their shape in a process called coagulation and making the meat shrink. Water gets squeezed out of the muscle, which begins to happen at around 100 to 120 degrees Fahrenheit, notably before the meat is cooked to a safe temperature to eat, which is at 145 degrees according to the USDA. The actin breaks down at higher temperatures from 150 to 163 degrees Fahrenheit. When that happens, your meat is going to get very firm as the process pushes even more water out. If we remove all of that moisture, we wind up with a dry, overcooked steak that's not going to impress anyone. And this is the reason professional chefs aren't so pleased when a customer requests their dish well done. It won't be juicy, and might even get sent back to the kitchen.
It's well done!
We're cooking our steak medium rare, so we'll remove it once it hits a critical 145 degrees Fahrenheit. At that point, you can safely remove your steak without worrying about getting sick. And now, it's all about how pink to brown a center you're aiming for. Once I take the steak off of the heat, it gives those coagulated myosin proteins a chance to relax a little bit. As the meat rests, the moisture that had been squeezed out of the muscle fibers has the opportunity to seep back in.
Sorry.
There's
about
a
that.
Lot of smoke.
Yeah.
Just about done.
145.
145. All right. Now the kitchen smells great. I'm ready to eat, but we need to let the meat rest. So we're gonna cover it with some foil, but how long do we wait before preparing and eating it? Let's start the clock. Recommended resting times may vary and will depend on the thickness of the cut and cooking methods used. Thin steaks or chops should rest 5 to 10 minutes, while thicker cuts can sit 20 to 30 minutes. Whole turkeys or large roasts are best left resting 40 minutes before carving. So how you spend that time is up to you. I did it when I was a kid.
What am I,
you
could do it. What am I supposed to do?
Over.
With this.
Grab the axe.
Okay.
Down. Yeah, perfect. That looks right. That look. I don't know.
Is that your card?
No.
This one?
Still no. And hold. Okay. There. Look. Look at you. Oh wait, that's not really a move. Time to wake you up.
You want to try?
No, that's pretty gristly. Ah. You can have that piece.
Mmm. This looks like more your size.
It is moist, you've done well. It's got its juices, and I wouldn't call it leathery. Well done. But not well done, but well done. How long do you let your steak rest? Share your experiences and tips in the comments, and if you like this video, subscribe below.